Wait. Wait for it. Nice. Welcome to another video about Windows. What else? This time it's about Windows Millennium, which is happily running on a Core i3 13th gen CPU, Raptor Lake generation. This is now possible thanks to a tiny patch called CrackFix. So when I say tiny, it's really tiny, only 33 bytes. This is the whole patch, but it's very effective. We have to run this patch in the other exec bot. Let's remove this patch and see what happens. Now let's restart. Well, this happens. We get the vcache Windows protection error. By the way, CrackFix is not from a dude named Crack, but from a control registry fix. The dude who made this fix, it's called Mintsuki. It's very active on GitHub. Now let's reset and put CrackFix back to work. Well, let's edit the autoexec bot. Now CrackFix is back. Let's reset. The problem with the Windows Millennium is that by default it doesn't process the autoexec bot. In an effort to leave those behind, this is the Windows Millennium policy. Anyway, there was much interest in bringing MS-DOS mode back to Windows Millennium, and this is exactly what I did. I installed a patch. Actually, this is not an option. If we want this line to be executed, we need MS-DOS mode, and I use this patch, which is a recompilation of older files and workarounds which were made over the years. And the good news is some of the core files of the patch are from Microsoft, and the patch is totally stable. The bad news is there is no Windows Millennium ISO already patched for MS-DOS mode. So you have to use a working Windows Millennium installation. This is the way I did it. I copied the program files, Windows folder, or exec bot, CrackFix, and anything that is necessary into a DOS bootable partition. Windows will start, we'll discover our devices once again. This is not a big issue. This is the way I did it. I'll check if this patch can be integrated during the Windows setup. Meanwhile, there is a download link in the video description. Now let me show you one thing that I like about Windows Millennium. Is that the fact we do have a DOS sound in Windows without any extra settings. It works right out of the box. MIDI, device detected, audio, device detected, done. Now let's check this game.
Five, four, three, two, one, go!
As you can see, it simply works, and no extra settings were needed. Of course, depends on what sound card you have, but with most common sound cards, it should be okay. Now let's start Quake, the DOS Quake, not the Win Quake. Well, it works, and there are no glitches. This is quite a good DOS machine, if you ask me. Now let me show you a quick hardware tour using my capture card. Besides the Intel Core i3 13th Gen CPU, I'm using a PCI Express ATI Radeon X300. Well, Windows ME can do better than this 64-bit GPU, but that's what I have right now. I'm using this business motherboard from Asus with one classic PCI slot, but one slot is not exactly enough. The slot is filled with this Creative Sound Blaster, a very common but very compatible sound card. Next, I'm using a PCI Express to PCI adapter for USB. And if you don't have any PCI classic PCI slots, you can use something like this, a PCI Express card, the embedded bridge chip, and a classic PCI sound chip like this one from C-Media. It simply works. I'm also using the onboard SATA. Now let me show you some benchmarks. Having USB can solve the internet issue very easily. I'm using a basic Wi-Fi dongle, which is connected to my newest router, no problems. And by the way, I have a factory here. This file is from December 999. If I go to Quake 3 multiplayer, there are working servers. And will they accept me? Of course. Oh no. This is quite interesting because I was expecting some updates to be needed, but what do you know? Now let's end the video without criticizing Windows Millennium, because as you may be aware, it's like the most criticized Windows ever. And yes, indeed, it has more flaws than Windows 98, but in the same time it's more advanced with more features, and with more features there are more bugs. Anyway, if you want to make it as stable as Windows 98, just disable the system restore function, and this option only will do wonders. And I guess that's it for now. Thanks for watching. See you next time.